So good morning, my dear 8th semester END students. Here I have tried a little differently this time. I don't know how much is acceptable from your side. After having seen the variable impedance type of series compensators, right? So now let us go on to the second part of this topic, that is the series compensators, which is based on the switching converter type of series compensators, right? So what are the various aspects of this switching converter type of series compensators? We shall see in our subsequent slides along with the explanation, and wherever possible editing, other things are required probably. So I should be able to do that also using this particular module of teaching. Okay, let us move on to the next slide now. See, when we speak about the switching converter type of series compensator, right, basically a voltage source converter with its internal control, right, which we have referred it to as the synchronous voltage source, right? So this is being made use of here, which is very much similar to our conventional generators, right? We have already seen the synchronous machine analogy earlier. Accordingly, we will have the similarity between a synchronous generator and a synchronous voltage source in order to realize switching converter type of series compensator, right? Now basically synchronous voltage source, right? So it is going to generate a set of alternating substantially sinusoidal voltages, right, at a desired fundamental frequency with controllable amplitude and phase angle for the purpose of generation or absorption of reactive power, right? So now a set of alternating voltages at a desired fundamental frequency with the controllable amplitude and phase angle. We have already seen in the very beginning of our discussions, right, as long as your amplitude of the voltage generated is controllable, we will be able to have the reactive power control. As long as phase angle is controllable, we will be able to exchange the real power also. That is the basic concept of switching converter type of series compensator, right? And it is capable of exchanging the real power with the AC system when its DC terminals are connected to energy storage device, right? So the real power exchange is only possible when you have got some energy storage element. It could be the BESS, right, battery energy storage system, or we have other type of the storage systems which we have discussed in our earlier discussions, right? So in this way, your SVS can be operated with a relatively small DC capacitor in a self-sufficient manner, like a static VR generator, to exchange real power with the AC system or with an external DC supply, like a static generator, or with an energy storage device also to exchange independently controllable real power. So it is possible for us also to have the control over the independently controllable real power, right, if you have an energy storage device, right? So these are the general concepts of our SVS, that is the synchronous voltage source, right, and which is very much analogous to your conventional generators, right? So now when we speak about the synchronous voltage source, right, let us try to see how exactly a synchronous voltage source can be functionally represented, right? Please look at the diagram here, whatever I have drawn this side. Okay, so this diagram basically represents a schematic of how a static series compensator can be conceived, right? You have got a coupling transformer, as you can see here, right? This coupling transformer's secondary is connected in series with the line here, right? Then the primary is connected to a voltage source converter, as you can see there, right? Then beyond the voltage source converter, you have got a DC link capacitor, and beyond that, if at all your objective is to exchange the real power, you can connect it to energy storage device, right? And for all these things, that means for the voltage source converter, which is the backbone of the entire operation here, right, you have the inputs or the controlling commands coming from a controller, what you can see here, right? And for this controller, you have P reference and Q reference as the input commands. P reference can also be represented as R reference, and Q reference can also be represented as X reference here, right? So now, as long as your control is on the reactive power, right, so then you will have only X reference. If you want to have the control over the real power also, you can also have the R reference. So now, if you want to exchange only the reactive power, then this particular P or R reference does not come into picture, right? So now, by doing so, you should be able to control the amplitude and phase angle of the generated output voltage necessary to exchange the desired reactive power as well as the real power, as long as your control is about the phase angle, right? So this is how the complete SVS is conceived, in order to exchange either the real power or the reactive power or both, depending upon the requirement, right? So this is the basic structure of how your SVS can be represented, okay? Now, with that background, we will move on to the next slide, wherein we discuss about the concepts of the static synchronous series compensator, SSC, right? So now, when we discuss about the SSC, please try to have a look at the first diagram here, the first diagram, right, which represents sending end voltage and a receiving end voltage. Then the entire line reactance is lumped as XL, across which the voltage is taken to be VL, right? Then P is the real power with the direction of the power flow, current I, and P. Now, in the conventional case, in the absence of XC, whatever we have here, right, in the absence of XC, the P would have been V square sine delta divided by XL, right? So now we have connected XC here, across which the voltage is VC, and the same thing is explained with the help of a phasor diagram as well, right? Now the phasor diagram very clearly shows that at a given line current, the voltage across the series capacitor, right, forces the opposite polarity voltage, right, across the series line reactance to increase the magnitude of the capacitor voltage, right? So in this way, the series capacitive compensation works by increasing the voltage across the impedance of the given physical line, which in turn increases the corresponding line current and hence the transmittable power, right? And now, one thing is that the decrease in the line reactance is not possible physically, as long as you reduce the line length, right? So basically, this is indirectly done by means of increasing the voltage across the given impedance of the physical line. So increasing the voltage across the given impedance of the physical line is basically conceived by having a capacitor here, right? So this concept, if it is only capacitor, how exactly the capacitor reactance is controlled, all those things we have seen in the variable impedance type of the series compensator. Now we shall see how would we replace this capacitor by means of the SVS, that is the synchronous voltage source, and accordingly how this particular scheme becomes more beneficial compared to the conventional the variable impedance type of series compensator, right? So now if you look at this diagram now, right, so now you please look at the bottom diagram, wherein except this part, right, all other parts remain as they are compared to the previous diagram, right? So now this is now being replaced, your VC or the capacitor is being replaced by a VQ, which is now acting as a static synchronous voltage source, or SVS, right? So now for the steady state power transmission, or the steady state power transmission can be established if the series compensation is provided by a synchronous AC voltage source, as shown in the figure below, whose output precisely matches with the voltage of the series capacitor, right? So now I have replaced your earlier scheme by VQ. Now VQ is equal to VC. VC is nothing but minus J into XC into I. So this XC is now replaced by K into X. So therefore this VQ becomes equal to minus J K into X into I, where your K is called as the degree of series compensation. VC is the injected voltage, voltage phasor. I is the line current. XC is the reactance of the series capacitor. XL is the line reactance. And K, as I already told you, is the degree of series compensation, right? Now, by making the output of the synchronous voltage source as a function of line current, again we are coming to the very point which is applicable to our switching converter type of compensator, right? So by making the output of the synchronous voltage source a function of line current, right, the same compensation as provided by a series compensator is accomplished. Now you may ask, why do you want to have VQ? You could have managed with VC itself or the C itself. There are certain advantages. I will come back to those things. Now, see here, in contrast to a real series compensator or real series capacitor, the SVC is able to maintain constant compensating voltage in presence of variable line current, or control the amplitude of the injected compensated voltage independent of the amplitude of the line current. This is the point from where we have begun with the discussion of the switching converter type of compensator, right? In case of the STATCOM, we have seen that the injected current is independent of the line voltage, and in the similar way in SSC, the injected voltage is independent of the line current. So therefore you get a better controllability here, right? So once if you get a better controllability, your scheme performs well here compared to its variable impedance type of counterparts, right? So now if you look at one more advantage here, this is another important thing. For the normal capacitive compensation, the output voltage lags the line current by 90 degree, but here this point you have to note down, this is very important. In this case we have the output voltage can be reversed by simple control action to make it lead or lag the line current by 90 degree. That means it is possible for us to have the operation even in the inductive region as we have the operation in the capacitive region, just by having the control over the triggering angle or the firing angle, which is capable of making your system to operate even in the leading power factor zone or the lagging power factor zone. This is one of the most important advantages. So that is the reason why you can see here the generalized expression for the injected voltage here, right, is written as VQ is equal to plus or minus, this plus or minus, both inductive as well as the capacitive region, right? Plus or minus J, VQ of zeta, zeta is a control function, right? I divided by I. I mean, you can see the two I's there. One is a dark I, another is a light I. The dark I refers to the rated line current. Small I represents the actual line current, right? So the capacitive injection, only, I mean the voltage injected, can be written as plus or minus JVQ to zeta, VQ of zeta into the line current, right? VQ of zeta is the magnitude of the injected compensated voltage, and it can vary from 0 to Vmax, and zeta is the chosen control parameter, right? Now we can have the definition of the SSC, but before that, let us look into this diagram, which represents the simple power angle characteristics as we have seen earlier. And as you can see here, there are five different curves of the power angle. So one, the middle one, represents the curve corresponding to the normal operation where you don't have any compensation. You can see there VQ is equals to zero, right? Now above that, you have got the positive value of VQ, or some value, some arbitrary values are taken there as per some case studies. So 0.353 and another is 0.707. as the degree of the series compensation increases, the maximum transmittable power also increases, right? And on the other hand, below that normal line, normal curve, right, you have VQ is equals to minus 0.353 and minus 0.707, which indicates, right, the power transmitted is going to be less. So that is when you have to swallow the excessive reactive power that is generated during the conditions of the receiving end voltage being more than the sending end voltage, maybe because of sudden removal of the load or the Ferranti effect or whatever it is, right? So like that kind of situations will even make your series compensators to work properly, right? So in this way, now let us try to have the definition which we have taken long back in your first unit in the beginning, right? So probably after having seen so much of things in that process, now you can appreciate this expression or the definition. The series reactive compensation scheme using a switching power converter, right, which is preferably a voltage source converter, as a synchronous voltage source to produce a controllable voltage in quadrature with the line current is termed as the static synchronous series compensator, right? So now this is one type of definition as per the IEEE, right? So you can have a small changes also without distorting the meaning of the very SSC, but it is expected that this kind of explanations are written, right, in order to make the things very clear, right? A series reactive compensation scheme using a switching power converter, which is preferably a voltage source converter, as a synchronous voltage source to produce a controllable voltage in quadrature with the line current. So this is termed as the static synchronous series compensator. Okay, so now once if you look at the structure of the static synchronous series compensator, quickly let us look into the VI characteristics as well, right? As we have seen the VI characteristics of so many other schemes earlier, right? So here, if you look at the VI characteristics, right, now this particular part, I mean, which is called as the voltage compensation mode, all right, for all the series compensators, we have taken the voltage compensation mode as well as the reactance compensation mode. In the similar way, here also we will be able to take that, right? So now this diagram very much resembles that of the STATCOM, right? The STATCOM has got similar characteristics, but there, here we had V and here we had I, because the STATCOM gives the current compensation, right, compared to the SSC, right? Now in the voltage compensation mode, again the explanations are very similar what we have taken for our GCSE as well as TCSE. The SCSC, the SSC can maintain the rated capacitive or inductive compensated voltage in face of the changing line current theoretically in the total operating range right from 0 to I maximum, right? But there we had I minimum and I maximum, right? So up to I minimum you will have to change the value of the reactance, then I minimum to I maximum you will have to change the angle gamma that we have already seen. But here it is not like that. Theoretically it is from I minimum to I maximum, but if you look at the practical characteristics, right, maybe they look something like this, right? If you look at the practical VI characteristics, right, it will it is not possible for us to provide the compensation at a very low value of the line current, right? So it may be about, you know, about 10% or 20%. Up to that you can have the practical cases, right? Now if you look at the second characteristics here, this side, this is the impedance compensation mode. In the impedance compensation mode, the SSC is established to maintain the maximum rated capacitive or compensative reactance at any line current up to the rated maximum. So you can see here, both in the inductive region as well as in the capacitive region, it is possible for us to provide the compensation. Unlike your GCSE and TSSE, even your TCSE is also capable of giving the compensation in either regions, that is the capacitive as well as the inductive region, right? So accordingly we can have the definition of VA rating also here. VA rating of your SSC, which is IMAX into VQ max, IMAX into VQ max, the VA rating, right? So it is written here, you can see here, VA rating of the SSC. So this is a very important term or very important parameter, as long as you know the VI characteristics of the SSC is concerned. Okay, now let us go into the next aspect of your SSC, that is the control structure, right? So we have seen the control structure for almost all the combinations earlier, right? We have seen the control structure of a STATCOM, we have seen the control structures of your GCSC and TCSC, right? Now here we shall see how exactly the control structure or the external control scheme plays its role, because in any switching converter type compensators, right, so your control circuit plays a very, very important role, right? The control circuit plays a very important role. So now you look at this diagram here. Okay, in this diagram, have a careful observation first, right? So what are the different blocks here, right? So how these blocks are derived, all those things you can have here. Now in this scheme, you have voltage or the current signal processor one, wherein the inputs to this are I, V and VQ, the one thing. Then you have got the power oscillation damping circuit, right? You have got the SSR damping circuit, and you have one more block which is called as the transient stability enhancement. These are all behaving as the external control systems, right? And very importantly, here you can see, right, you have got one operating mode selection, right? So operating mode selection means what? In which mode you are operating, right? Whether you want to have the operating mode only in the reactive compensation mode or in the voltage compensation mode, whether you want to have both the real as well as the reactive power exchange. We have already spoken about R reference as well as you know, P reference earlier, right? R reference and P reference. So if you want to have the real power exchange, you will have R reference as well as the P reference, otherwise not. So that all those things will be decided. You can see here, there is a selector here, right? This selector, this will take care of you know, making the proper selection of whichever the mode you want to have, right? Then now all those outputs, I mean the external blocks output, one is the power system oscillation damping, right? This is one of the you know, objectives of our series compensation we have seen, right? The power oscillation damping SSR damping, the subsynchronous resonance damping, right? The transient stability enhancement. Please look at the different inputs that are given. In the power oscillation damping, it is the frequency variation or delta F, and the power is the input. And in the SSR damping, it is the frequency as well as the phase angle, right? Whatever the variables you are feeding in are the frequency variation as well as the phase angle variation. And for the enhancement of the transient stability, again the frequency as well as the power, right? These are the different inputs that are given, and these inputs are given to a summing circuit. Here you can see here the summing circuit, right? And the very measured quantities of voltage, current, right? So they are fed through the PI controller, and this goes to a series reactive compensator. Finally, depending upon the firing angle which is given here, right, as per the calculations whatever are taking place here, right, so you will be able to have the injection of the voltage as decided by the various controlling parameters here. The same thing is written here. The main power flow control is executed by a slow loop. I mean, the external loop will be a slower loop, right, closed loop, which is operated from one of the selected references. It could be XQ reference or VQ reference or I reference or P reference, depending upon whether you want to have only the reactive power control or you want to have the control over the real power as well. At the similar time, you want to have the operation in the voltage compensation mode, or you want to have the operation in the reactance compensation mode, right? So accordingly, the corresponding network variables XQ or VQ or I or P is derived by the voltage and current processors and compared to the selected reference. The amplified error at the output of the PI controller provides the reference XQ or VQ for the internal control. This is how the entire scheme works as far as the external control is concerned. Now, XQ and VQ are the values for the internal control. Let us try to see how exactly the internal controller works for this particular scheme, right? Now, here, the same diagram I have taken here. The auxiliary control signals to improve the transient stability and dynamic stability and also temp subsynchronous oscillations are derived from the different variables. This I have already taken, the different system variables, right? Now, system frequency variation, power flow variation or subsynchronous oscillation damping from the torsional variations, right? When they are available, they are synthesized from the locally measured voltage and current, right, by the powers oscillation damping, transient stability enhancement and subsynchronous oscillation damping, auxiliary control circuits, and fed directly as a reference to the internal control circuit. So now this is again the continuation from whatever we had in the previous slide. Now this I have already explained in the previous slide. The different variables obtained either directly or from the corresponding controlled measured variables, they are taken and they are provided through the PID controller and they are provided to the internal control of your controller of the series compensator. In the internal controller, basically your XQ or your another parameter is as we have seen in the previous page, that is VQ, XQ and VQ, right? XQ and VQ, right? These are the main reference parameters. They are provided here and that will generate the gate logic pattern, which is the performance to be done by the internal circuitry, right, or internal loop. So you got one external loop here, right, or the external controller, and one internal controller, right? So togetherly, all the parameters related to whatever is required for the control of the injected voltage here, they are measured, compared, and accordingly you generate the gate pattern logic here, right? So once the gate pattern logic is generated, the appropriate voltage is going to be injected here. Now it is not as easy as what I said here, because the control circuits become very complicated, because it is a series compensating circuit. The entire controller is connected in series with the line. The line is subjected to the transients, the external faults. So many parameters are to be looked into. That is the reason why probably you would see more number of blocks compared to any other kind of the controllers we have discussed so far, right? So all these blocks are responsible for the proper and accurate operation of the entire control scheme. Okay, now this is about the series compensator and its associated control scheme, SSC. Please have the comparison of this series compensators with its shunt counterpart. But now we will have the summary of the characteristics taken here, right? This summary is as applicable to the series compensators only. Now all the four diagrams, VI characteristics, are drawn in a single slide so as to make it easy for you to make the comparison. So please look at the GCSE. In the GCSE, you have the compensation only at one side, that is the VC. So is the TSSC. So GCSE and TSSC, they almost resemble. That is a valid reason also for that. We have seen how exactly the GCSE and TSSC are equivalent, right? Then your TCSE, a very important one, wherein if you look at the TCSE and your SSC, they have similarities in the way that both the inductive as well as the capacitive compensation is possible, right? But if you look at the GCSE and your TSSC, the compensation is possible only in the capacitive region. Inductive region, it is not possible, right? So now if you look at the basic characteristics here, SSC is a voltage source type, whereas your GCSE, TCSE and TSSC are the variable impedance type, right? The voltage source character of SSC offers some inherent capabilities and functional features of for series line compensation, which may not be attainable in the case of impedance type compensators. Very simple reason is that the injected voltage is independent of the line current, whereas here whatever the voltage you are going to inject, they are dependent on the line current and the physical properties of the capacitors which are used there, right? So now if you come to the variable impedance type, the circuit structure, the power semiconductor devices used are the thyristor controlled variable impedance type of compensators, offers easy accommodation of the necessary protection features required to handle line fault current. So now we have discussed in our second topic that the thyristors or the SCRs have got certain inherent advantages over its line commutated counterpart, right? Yet whatever the advantages we have discussed in the as far as the SCRs are concerned, so those advantages are encashed here in the GCSE or the TCSE or in the TCSE or in the TCSE. But the advantages of the devices which are deployed in your GCSE, that is the self-commutated devices, GTO devices, they are going to be encashed in the GCSE devices. Okay, now if you look at the other aspects here, the SSC is capable of internally generating a controllable compensating voltage over identical capacitive and inductive region independent of the magnitude of the line current. This I've already told you. Basically, it is the gist or the summary of whatever we have discussed so far, right? So if you again look at the SSC, it has the inherent ability to interface an external DC source. That means the real power exchange is possible only in the SSSC, right? Whereas your all the variable impedance counterparts are limited to the reactive power exchange. So therefore, this is a very important point to be noted. Now, you look here, the next point, the GCSC and SSSC use GTO thyristors. These devices presently have lower voltage and current ratings, considerably lower short-term surge current rating. They are suitable for short-term bypass operation only if the anticipated line current is relatively low. Very, very important point to be noted, right? Your GCSC and SSSC, their rating is limited compared to that of the TSSC. I'm not able to write it properly. Anyway, you can appreciate it. GCSC and SSSC are having the limited rating, whereas your TSSC and TCSC are having the higher rating because of the very limitation of the devices that are used with the lower current and voltage rating, and accordingly lower short-term surge current rating, right? Now, this is one important difference between the individual types if you compare separately, right? Now, if you come to the other type, which is written in the black color here, the compensating voltage of the GCSC and TCSC over the given control range is proportional to the line current, is proportional to the line current, but here it is independent of the line current on the other side. The TSSC can maintain the maximum compensating voltage with the decreasing line current over the control range determined by the current boosting capability of the thyristor controlled reactor, right? The variable impedance type of series compensators cannot exchange the real power. This I have already told you here, this side, as the SSSC can be used to even exchange the real power, but the variable impedance type cannot exchange the real power with the transmission line and can only provide the reactive compensation, right? And the TSSC and TCSC employ conventional thyristors with no internal turnoff capability. These thyristors are most rugged power semiconductor devices and available with the highest current and voltage ratings, and they also have very high surge current capability, right? So now, in the last two slides here, right, I have the summary of characteristics. Sometimes certain characteristics are common to two devices or more, and certain characteristics are not at all common, they are independent of the devices, right? So now what I expect you to is, in the next slide or whatever the assignment you can take, right? So what you do is, you make four columns like this. First you take GCSC, then you take TSSC, thyristor switched series capacitor, then TCSC, thyristor controlled series capacitor, and finally you take SSSC, okay, and you please make the comparison based on the different points individually applicable to these devices, right? So now with that, right, so probably we have come to the end of this particular topic, right? Here I have tried to go with a slightly different method, wherein I wanted some things to be written here, and the explanation is given to the entire 10 or 12 slides at once compared to what I used to do earlier, right? So let us see how good it is as per your feedbacks. Most of you, unfortunately, not most of you, none of you have given any kind of the feedback so far about the process that is going on here. I request you to please kindly put your feedback in the Google Classroom comment section so that it is easier for me to make the modifications or whatever the changes I wish to make here, right? So any other discussion, any other things are necessary here, we will again come back and we will try to have the discussion along with your all friends, right? So let us make it more interactive, and accordingly I will give you some assignments also on this particular topic, and you will have to submit, and that carries your CTA marks, right? So if you have any doubt, please get back to me, and In the same way, whatever the conventional method I used to follow using a PowerPoint presentation with the voice command, that also I will upload, and along with this also you can just have as the reference. Okay, so this discussion went for almost 40 minutes now, but somewhere I have gone little fast also, because this is for the first time that I am doing this kind of activity. I don't know how to make it sectionalized. It is not possible for me to make it sectionalized. If it is possible, that also I will make. And you please try to listen to these things and take the notes also. Make the notes. Making the notes is very important. In the class, you used to make the notes, but since we are distant now, I am not able to follow whether you are making any notes or not, right? But please do make the notes. That will be a very important and most valid type of justification that you have learned something, you are in the process of learning. Okay, thank you.